It's very important that we encourage the community to have their input into the fire management emergency plans, because if we can get that local knowledge and capture that, we can be in the best spot to get the best plan with the most strongest conditions and understanding of what the local conditions are that affect the local people in our communities. Well, the plans involve developing a response to fire management and also some township protection plans so that we can have our small towns protected in the event of a bushfire, but also to give some comfort to the community around how they can be best prepared for any upcoming fire season. The City of Ballarat is hosting 4 community consultations. We're encouraging the community to be involved. There are a number of other community conversations at other municipalities, but we're really encouraging people to get involved and have their say to give us that local knowledge.
I'm Don Kelly, I'm the Regional Manager for CFA for Grampians Region, and I'm also Chair of the Regional Strategic Fire Management Planning Committee, which is responsible for fire planning right across the Grampians Region. And where we are today is that we're ready to launch public consultation about the plans which have been now in development over the last 2 years. It involves all the local government councils plus the agencies involved. And so we've now got the plans up to a stage where we're going to go out to 20 locations around this area and try and engage the community to get their feedback on have we got it right, whether there's enhancements that can be made before those plans go to councils in November and December. There is 20 meetings planned, which they're welcome to come at. They're not a come and be lectured at, they're come and have a conversation. So we'll explain to individuals or groups exactly where the plans are heading, what the significant risks are, how those risks are planned to be treated, and whose responsibility it is to treat those risks. As well, the plans will be on both municipal websites and on CFA websites, so people can get access to them, and online feedback is quite welcome, as is direct at the meetings. At this stage, there's plenty of grass around, and if we get some good spring rain, I think there'll be a significant grass fire season this year. The forest has at least got a bit more moisture in it, so it might be delayed a bit longer, but we're very dependent on weather conditions in the next 2 or 3 months.
Craig Lapsley, Fire Service Commissioner for Victoria. The key thing that we're in Ballarat announcing today is that in the Grampians region and in the immediate Ballarat area, the 5 municipalities around the Ballarat area are launching a new community consultation program to assist work with communities to build township protection plans. So there's 30 locations in the 5 municipalities around the greater Ballarat area that will now work through with communities to get input to the township protection plans and also feedback of how they'll operate. Now the reason this is important is this is a pilot about how we consult. So we're trying to learn from communities about the best way to engage with them, and knowing that some communities are quite different, that there might be more than one way about how we sit and work through the plans. Some other communities will have ideas of how that plan should look and feel, so we'll take those issues away and get a better understanding. The Township Protection Plan, the plan in which they're consulting over, is a plan that describes the location and the risk of the town. So where am I and what's around me that will potentially burn, and to what extent would it burn? And if it does burn, what's it do to the town, and if you're part of that town, what should you do? So it still doesn't take away that people should have an individual plan or a plan for their household or a plan for the neighbourhood. This is a plan that looks at the township and raises all the issues about what will happen in that town, what are the places in there that will be there to assist them. Should they even be there? You know, should it be, where would I go if I'm not in that town? So it raises lots of issues. It tries to prompt the options that people should take. And it's new since the 7th of February 2009. This is the second year we would have had the Township Protection Plans, and we're looking to evolve them further to be a more useful plan.
When we actually look at bushfire planning throughout the region or throughout the state, there are basically 3 main areas that we're concerned about. Firstly, we're concerned about protection or primacy of life. That's our number one consideration or concern that we're dealing with. We're secondly interested in being able to offer protection for homes, assets and livelihoods. And thirdly, when we deal with bushfire planning, it's all about trying to ensure that the community is appropriately prepared, and that any impact to the environment is minimised through the impact of bushfire. The community tends to be heading towards a state of apathy again in relation to bushfire planning. He's concerned that people are already forgetting some of the lessons learned as a result of Black Saturday, and that people are actually letting their guard down. So what we're actually aiming to do as part of this bushfire planning process is to raise the level of awareness and alertness of the community so that we can actually try and mitigate risk.
Lance and Judith Lewis from Mount Helen, and we read the, or got a letter from the council inviting us to this one or one at Bunnyong. We came along to see what's going on, because I'm busy for the rest of the week. I was mainly interested in what the poor CFA are trying to do with something which is an extremely difficult thing. It is not their fault that the state burns.
They've classed Mount Helen as extremely dangerous area, and we don't, well, I don't think it's that bad. So we were just interested to see what that is that they have got planned, you know, whether they want everybody to cut their gardens to, you know, 6 inches high or whatever.
We have got a tree covered block. It is, in fire situations, probably relatively high risk. I understand that, and that is something that I'm prepared to accept.